We shall now learn how to write a custom action filter for authentication. First of all, you should understand the problem. Consider this situation that I have one action. This is one action and this is another action. Action method and this is action method. Now I want this particular action to be called only by authenticated users, and this action can be called by any user. Now one way of checking the authentication in this action method is to write code here to check whether the user is authenticated or not. But if I have 10 such methods, then I will have to copy paste this code everywhere, or maybe at least manually call a function here. The best way to do this is to write your custom action filter. Custom action filter is an attribute that you can apply on an action method, so that the code for that attribute is called before the action method is called or after the action method is called. Various overloads are there in the base class. We can implement the various overrides to decide on the timing at which the particular code will run. So if I want to write a, see this one for example, this is public action result fx. On this I apply a cust auth filter, cust auth attribute. Now this is an action filter. That is implemented by implementing 4 overrides from the parent class. Those 4 overrides are available for deciding the timing at which the code in that will be called. You can call the code in that before action result, before this function fx is executed, or after this is executed, or before the result action result is returned, or after the action result is returned. Custom authorization filter will typically run before the action result, before the action method is called, so that in case the user is not authorized, this function is not called at all. This is one thing. Since we are discussing the topic, I want to discuss one more thing here. MVC allows you to write filters that can be called before every action method. So one type of specification is you can specify that a particular filter is called before any action method of your project. Just like we specify CSS properties in an outside CSS file, they'll apply to any, let us say, div element. Then you can specify styles on a particular element coming closer to that element. Similar is the case here also. Either you specify that a particular filter is called before any action method, and you can specify that a particular attribute or action filter is called before a given action by putting it closer to that action. So how to apply the first one and how to apply the second one? The closest analogy I could think was of the CSS one. Like you can put some specification in the CSS file, and then you can put certain specification closer to that element in the style tag. Similar is the case with this. First